Finally, I am sharing the recipe of homemade pasta. We are making ribbon macaroni today. Everyone will enjoy, guys. Hey foodies, welcome to CookingShooking. Let's make pasta at home and Indian style macaroni with it. So here I have Suji or Semolina. It is also known as Bombay Rava. It is 1 cup, which is about 175 gram. We will add it to a mixer jar and make a powder. This much quantity will be good for 3 to 4 people if you are making it for a snack. If you are making it as a meal, it will be good for 2 people. Make a powder. The powder consistency should be something similar to rice flour. Right now I can still feel a few grains, so I'm going to put on the lid again and turn on the mixer again to make a finer powder. Now it looks good. We will take it out into a kneading plate. Here I have a parat. You can also take it out into a mixing bowl. We will take 1 teaspoon of salt, and then here I have some water. I have taken half a cup of water for now. We will add little water at a time and make a dough. The dough should be semi-stiff, guys. If the dough is very soft, then the pasta will not hold its shape. And you know, Suji is very fond of drinking water, so be very careful with the quantity of water. Don't add a lot of water at once. Add a few spoonfuls of it and then try to make a dough. So here you can see I have made the dough, but we have not kneaded it right now. The dough is kind of breaking very easily. So now we have to knead it for about 4 to 5 minutes minimum, and the dough is stiff, and as we are kneading it, there will be a lot of friction, and because of the warmth of our hands, the moisture will dry. So what do I mean by that? You have to keep adding little water at a time even right now and then knead it. And because the dough is stiff, it will be very hard to knead it. But kneading is important, so you can ask for some help from the family and they'll happily help, especially for a recipe like this one. It's been about 4 minutes of kneading and you can see the difference in the dough. Earlier it was breaking immediately and right now it is stretching a little bit. About 2 or 3 inches it is stretching, so I am sprinkling some more water and then we will knead it for a minute more. The crucial thing is to maintain a stiff dough. The dough is ready. We have kneaded it for about 5 minutes. Now I'm going to apply some water in the dough, cover it with a cloth and let it rest for about 15 minutes minimum. If you have more time, you can also let it rest for about 45 minutes. I have given it 30 minutes, guys, and here you can see the texture of the dough has changed a little bit. It has become smoother and pliable, but it is not sticky at all. Now, let's divide it into 4 portions. Why am I doing that? Because Suji dries out very fast, guys, and we don't want the dough to dry. Then again, you'll have to sprinkle some water and make it smoother. So it's better to divide into 4 portions. Keep the 3 portions away in a damp cloth and work on 1 portion at a time. So for that, here I have a chakla or a rolling board. We are going to take 1 portion and roll it into a thin sheet. If the dough is sticking to the billen like this, then you can sprinkle a little bit of dry maida or some suji as you wish. We will have to roll it very thin, guys, because when we cook the pasta, it will double up in thickness. So after rolling it, you can feel the dough. Wherever it is thick, you can roll it more in that area. For me, this is ready. So now here I have a pizza cutter. You can also use a knife. We will cut this into strips. It should be about 1/2 inch apart. So long strips are ready. Now we will have to divide it into 1-inch big pieces. We are basically making ribbon macaroni right now. 1/2 inch by 1 inch pieces are ready. Now take one and try to pinch in the center. This is the most easiest and the fanciest looking shape, guys. The best part is it will also hold a lot of the sauce and the spices. So here our macaroni is ready. Let's keep it in the parat or a plate. Don't keep it in a bowl. We want it to dry a little bit. So for that, try to keep it in a big plate. Now you just have to repeat the same process like over 100 times to make all the macaroni. Perfect thing to do in this lockdown. In between, as you are making it, if you find a dough piece which is way too small, then what you can do is stretch the dough something like this and then try to pinch in the center. This one is also done. I made this yesterday also and it's quite time consuming, but the taste of this is such that everyone will come together in the kitchen and make this recipe possible. Most of the macaroni is done and here I have a little bit of the dough scrapes, basically the corner pieces of the dough. What you can do with this is sprinkle some water into it, knead it for a minute and then you can roll it again to make the macaroni. Here the macaroni is ready. Before cooking them, just ensure they are dry. It takes about 20 minutes to make all the macaroni and just about 20 minutes to dry them also. So as you make them, they should be dry already. Here you can see how they are moving when I try to shake them, which means they are not stuck together and they are dried also. So now let's cook them. Here I have some water boiling. In this I am adding about 1 teaspoon of salt. Be careful with the salt quantity. The packaged macaroni many times don't have salt. So we are adding salt in the macaroni also and we are adding salt in the water also. Now let's add the macaroni and then we will boil it for about 5 to 6 minutes. I'm also adding a little bit of oil into this and then I will try to move them a little bit because we don't want them to stick to the bottom. As they cook, they will float on top. See how these ones are already floating? With time, all of them will float. Unlike packaged macaroni, this type of pasta will get harder as you cook them, in the sense when you add them to the boiling water they are soft and as you cook them for like 5 minutes they will get harder. Packaged one is opposite. I prefer to cook them for about 5 to 6 minutes and for me these are done, so I am turning off the flame right now and transferring them through a colander. Since I'm making Indian style macaroni, I'm not saving the water. You can save the water if you are making any other type of pasta. Wash the macaroni once with the cold water and this is done. Now let's make the Indian style pasta. So for that, here I have a kadai heating up. In this I'm adding 2 tablespoons of oil. As the oil heats up, I'm adding 5 cloves of garlic which is finely chopped. We will cook it for a minute, then we will add 1 large onion which is sliced. Cook that again for a minute and here I have the vegetables. In that I have taken 1 capsicum, 1 medium carrot and about 3 French beans. Along with this I am adding a little bit of salt to season and in the masala here I have the Maggi Masala magic. This will do all the work of the masalas. So 1 packet will go in. We will give it a stir and cook it for about 2 to 3 minutes. If you want the vegetables to be very soft, then you'll have to cook it for about 5 to 6 minutes. So here for me, crunchy masaledar vegetables are ready. To make it saucy, I'm taking about 2 tablespoons of tomato ketchup and about 1 tablespoon of Schezwan sauce. This is basically Schezwan chutney, guys. We will give it a stir, cook it for a minute. After that, we will add a little bit of fresh coriander leaves and the pasta. Does that look homemade? Not to me, guys, even I am surprised. So now let's give it a stir and cook it for about 2 minutes. So here our homemade macaroni is ready and it usually doesn't happen that I feel proud myself to see a recipe that I made. But today it is different, guys. You must definitely try this recipe. I'm sure you would enjoy. It's a very easy recipe and taste is such everyone would enjoy. I'm serving it in a bowl with some coriander leaves and cheese as a topping. This is basic cheese cube. Not compulsory to add it, but do try it. I'm sure you would totally enjoy. See you soon with one more video. Do subscribe to CookingShooking for more such yummy recipes. Bye guys, take care, happy cooking and stay safe.